What does stewardship mean at T. Rowe Price? How does it come alive? What do you do to make it so?
Stewardship means you did a great job for your clients. And it boils down to two basic things, I think. A lot of considerations, but two basic things. First and foremost, over the long period of time, we've done a really good job for investors delivering good investment results. Secondly, is we've taken good care of our clients from a servicing standpoint and given them a good client experience. If we do those two things really well over time, we'll do well.
One thing you have done to put customers first and to have their interests come even ahead of your own is you have been way out front in closing funds when they get to a size that you deem too big to continue strong performance. How do you tell? How do you judge when a fund is too big to succeed?
Well, it has been a hallmark of the company over multiple decades. It is always a judgment call when we think a fund is either too big or getting inflows at too fast a pace. And it is a dialogue between the heads of our investment divisions and the portfolio managers themselves, how they feel about managing those clients' assets. If they feel very, very good about it, they have lots of good ideas, we usually proceed. It's when they start to have caution that we tend to close the funds.
How have your expenses changed over the last, say, decade? Are they down? Are they lower? And what kind of pressure has that put on you in the CEO role to keep revenues up and profits high?
It's a balancing act, Tyler. We continue to invest in our business to improve our capabilities, to improve our ability to perform and deliver service. At the same time, we're always looking for efficiencies in the back and middle office because prices, fees, are on a slightly downward trajectory. They tend to go down a little bit over the course of every couple of years, but it's not a panic situation. So I think it's a manageable one for us. We're always looking for efficiencies where we can find them, but then again, reinvesting back into things that drive client satisfaction.
When I think of the history of T. Rowe Price, I think of T. Rowe Price himself and the fund company that he gave birth to as principally a fundamental research-driven shop, number one, and number two, an emphasis on growth. All of that adds up to mean, I think, that you guys truly believe that there is an advantage in active management over passive management, or you would have gone another way.
We absolutely do. The vast majority of our business is active management. We've invested a lot over multiple decades in building a global investment platform that we think can deliver alpha to our clients, using a spirit of collaboration and helping each other around the world. And this has paid off for our clients. We've done a very good job, as Morningstar has documented over the course of time, over the long term. Key element here, though, Tyler, is the long term and making sure that we're placing investments today that are going to pay off 5 and 10 years down the road for our clients.
Where's the money going today? Where is it flowing from today?
The investments within our company are going in several places, quite frankly. We're investing a lot to build our ESG platform. We have a multi-year, very substantive process whereby each of our products will have very strong awareness of ESG and all the elements and factors from that impact stock prices. And we'll be able to talk to our clients through that lens as well. We're also, like many others, investing in big data analytics. And mm-hmm. I think this is a long-term R&D project. There are lots of little wins along the way, but you have to keep investing and keep putting research dollars behind that to make it keep happening for the long term.